Alright, we're here with Coach Woody and Drinking Talk on the Top of Time pregame show.
All right, Coach. Hey, we got to go through it because just like we win, we talk about it. So when we lose, we talk about it too, and we talk about and we lose with our heads held high, our chins up, and we on to the next. Now, you face probably the best team you can face all year, and that's just being real. You know, they got a well-oiled machine over there. They were well-coached, but at the same time, it wasn't the blowout that everybody was expecting. And at the fourth quarter, it was 28-21. So just talk to us a little bit about how proud you are, your guys, but and what you learned from that game.
Well, it's a three-phase game, right? Offense, defense, special teams. And within the special team aspect of the game, you've got to control field position. And I don't feel like we controlled field position. With our returns, I mean, we would drop the kickoff and then have to kneel it. We didn't turn the ball over. But we had a long way to go to get where we
big
needed
drives,
to get.
Big
yeah.
drives, yeah.
And then we, like I said, a couple of punts went awry, yeah. if you will. And but you know, it's the snap, it's the protection. They brought heat, and we didn't have a good punt, if you will. And so we gave them field position.
Yeah.
That touchdown right before halftime. When it became 28-14, that hurt us.
And that's the field position battle that you hear people talk about, because you think about where we started. We were starting probably at our own 18 or 19, average 18 or 19 yard every time, and they were starting well over their 50-yard line every time. So when you got a tough team like that, it's hard to overcome the field position. So it's fair to say we lost the field position battle. But at the same time, we were able to stay close, you know? Yeah, I mean, great effort.
I mean, hey, there's nothing wrong with the fact that they gave everything that they had.
Yeah.
And that's what we talked about after the game. I appreciate your effort, but we got to, if we want to win the big game, because there's a team that's going to come up that's just like what we just faced, we got to make sure that we handle all three phases of the game. And we played disciplined.
Yeah, you did.
And we didn't have very many
penalties.
And we won the turnover battle.
Yep. Two turnovers.
Yeah, and the thing is, we got that turnover down here and had to go
96 yards.
And that's tough against that defense.
Yeah,
50 in the middle.
Yeah, because you gotta. I mean, when you're on the goal line, you gotta punch it out with a run or two. But I mean, they were stout up front.
Yes, sir.
I mean,
yes, sir.
From the D line to the linebackers. Kudos to them. But again, man, I was proud of our boys, man. You know.
We gave ourselves a chance.
Yep.
We got a good football team.
I'm proud of my team. No doubt.
Now, resiliency is of the utmost importance. They got to forget about that loss. We got to go into this week fresh and clean, and you hear it. They're ready. They're right.
And that's the difference right there. Like, when you come out here, the energy, and there's no layover. It's like these guys have been chucking along all year. You know, it's over with, done with, forget about it. Let's move on, whole new year.
You should have been here yesterday.
Yeah.
It was tight. It got ramped up.
Okay, okay.
So all-state team and the first team D, they were in their grills, each other. They were.
Yeah, that's that chip you need.
That chip. Yes, sir. Absolutely.
That's like brothers. That's real brothers. You fight on at home, but when you can't nobody else fight you when you get out there on the field. Mm-hmm. So, hey, that's a good thing. Jay Freshman, any final thoughts about the LCA game, my G?
I hated the loss. I feel like we should have won.
Yep.
And that punt killed us.
Mm, two of them.
Yeah. Mm. And the drop kick returns.
Yep.
Mm. And
he knows what's up.
And their stout offensive line in number 8.
Mm, he was all over the place, wasn't he?
Uh huh.
He was on our
no
grill.
No doubt.
Uh-huh. You're right, Jay Fresh. Yep. I respect. I mean, again. I ain't hang out with Jay Fresh a whole lot on Friday night. I tried to run from him because I knew what he was thinking.
Hey, but you know what, Jay Fresh? Hey,
we're
still here. We're still toppers.
Yeah.
And we're still going to keep rocking. And we're going to roll our way to the state championship. What you think?
Yeah.
All right, now. This has been Coach Woody. We'll be right back. All right. Now, we are here with our G-Fog Glass Football alumni. Defensive player of the game, Mr. Mikey Rohan Marley Jr. Thomas. Mikey, how you doing today, brother?
Good. How about you?
Doing good, man. Hey, had a tough game Friday, but hey, You know, you ain't lose to no scrubs. You ain't lose to no bums. It was a good team. Y'all guys were physical. I'm sure they banged up. You guys may be a little banged up. You know, it was a physical game. That's what you expect. But despite all that, you had a great game, man. So just talk a little bit about how you got down on Friday, man, and what was the feeling out there?
The feeling. I mean, I was, to be honest, I was shocked. Like, you know, playing at the LU Stadium, that's just a different type of experience. Yeah. So I was always like happy for that. Yeah. But you know, I was just feeling like I was missing tackles. So you know, I was pretty mad at myself. So I had to get out of my head and just play how I play.
No doubt. What you got for him, Jay Fresh?
Do you think we're gonna do? It's gonna be a good game.
Yes, sir. I think it's gonna be a good game this week.
Yeah, they're good, man. We're both 8-2, and obviously we're in the playoffs, so everything good.
Yes, sir. Definitely can't underestimate them.
Ask him about what happened last Friday, man. You know
what happened Friday?
Man, all credit to them. They just outplayed us that night.
Yeah. And this, hey, you know one thing? Hey, that's what it's about right there. It's just called respect, man. You don't make no excuses. You don't do no hating that man. Hey, they took an L. Congratulations to the Bulldogs. That's how you're supposed to carry yourself as a student athlete. No hating.
Yes, sir.
But this has been Mikey Thomas, the G5 Defensive Player of the Week. We out.
All right. We're back with the G5 Glass Football Alumni. Oh my God! Offensive Player of the Week, Mr. George White. George, how you doing today, brother?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing good, man. Hey, George. Going back to last Friday night, man. I'm gonna tell you, you showed some real toughness, man. You showed some toughness out there. You showed you can stand in the pocket and deliver the ball. And you know what I was most proud of you for? Them wheels. You was moving with your wheels. But just take us through that game, man. Just talk to us about, you know, how it was playing LCA and just, you know, how you guys fared with it.
Yeah, well, I was really happy with how hard we played. You know, we didn't execute offensively like we wanted to.
Yeah.
We executed well in the first half for a while. They showed us a look that we were not prepared for. They gave us 3 safeties. And a 4-man box, and we
I heard that before, right?
We struggled to run the ball. So we were really limited in what we could do. We became one-dimensional. It's hard to throw when they drop 8. But early on in the game, you know, we hit some big ones to 3 and 14, which has been the story for us all year.
No doubt.
And then I was able to run the ball a little bit. They didn't really rush the passer like I thought they would. They were more punching and reading. So
yeah.
I had some lanes to run through. But,
no doubt. And that just tell you how cerebral you are as a quarterback. Because for you to be able to notice what's going on in the game throughout the game, man. And I've been parlying with your coach over here, man. We're going to get you calling the game from the line like Peyton Manning, man. I told him you can do it. So we're going to get you calling the shots from the game, man. We're going to put it all on your shoulders.
Hey, he already does, boss.
Yo, okay. Well, hey, I know it's not true. Woody, he already, hey, your coach right here was fraudulent and they're talking about he called the plays. But we found out last week. Coach Ray was the ones to call
Coach
the play.
Ray holds his hand a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, man. So, yeah, he been putting out a lot of fraudulent information. But, Jay Fresh, what you got for George before we get out of here, brother?
They was on you all night last game, huh?
Yeah, yeah. They had some dudes on defense. Middle linebacker is a really, really good player. He showed some weird blitzes that only he could do, I think.
Yes, sir.
Then there was one time he showed blitz, saw I was throwing, dropped out, just tipped the ball. I was like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. But, no, that they were really, really good, and I need to be better at the end of the game.
Yeah, and game management, too.
Yeah, it's true. We need to execute better on offense, and we didn't.
Hey, George, I think we might need to sit down with Jay Fresh, man, and get the game plan for this week and let him call the plays. You know, Jay Fresh on it, ain't he?
No, I heard Jay Fresh talking about their offensive line, the number 8. He's on
it.
He knows.
Yeah.
Jay Fresh, the man. Jay Fresh, the man.
Yeah.
Hey, but this has been me, Trey Ken,
and
Jay Fresh.
And George White.
And yes, George sir. White. Tell him, we are what?
Ow!
Now we're back with the G5 Glass Football Alumni Unsung Hero of the Week. We're here with Mr. Teyon Mosby. Teyon, man, voted on by your coaches and your peers. You're a star on the field. You're a star in practice. You do whatever it takes, man. I mean, whether it's in the live action or it was leadership, man, you do it all. Just talk to us a little bit about what you bring to the table, bro.
Well, really, I'm just out here to, like, set a good example for the younger ones coming up and try to, like, get everybody to participate and stuff. So, like, basically, like you said, a good leader. And I try to lead by a great example by doing the things I do.
Doug, what you got for him, Jay Fresh?
What you think about Louisa?
I think Louisa is a good team, but I feel like we play our A game, Louisa can't hang with us.
Yeah, I don't think they can hang with us neither, even though we got the same record. We're better than them.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, like I said, even though we have the same record, Louisa really can't hang with us.
And you know what, Tamo, you get a lot of PT on both sides of the ball, man. You're like a big factor in the thing. And for you to be able to come out here and do scout team work and do other type of things like that, man, that just shows what type of player you are, what type of mentality you have. You're a team first guy, man. We appreciate it. And so this has been the GFA Unsung Hero for this week, Mr. Tayon Mosby. We'll be right back with Drippington.
Woody Tan. And first off, I gotta ask you, Coach.
Yes, sir.
Do you think it's gonna Louisa and Glass are both 8-2?
Yes, sir.
Do you think it's gonna be a defensive game?
Man, I think it's gonna be a defensive game. I think defense wins championships. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they got a pretty big fullback.
Man, they got a pretty big couple people. You uh-huh. See that number 97?
Yeah.
That number 52?
Yeah.
Yo, gosh. And the fullback is a monster.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like we can expose their corners.
Yeah, well, that's the plan. Don't tell anybody. Yes, sir.
And it's going to be raining, so you hopefully we can hold on to the ball if we got to run it.
Well, and hopefully we can catch the ball when we throw it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's going to be wet.
Yes, sir. We got to have a lot of towels, don't we?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we'll be all right. We'll be all right. See, the thing is on offense, when we run routes, we know where we're going mm-hmm. when it's wet. So mm-hmm. we have the upper hand. Mm-hmm. They don't know where mm-hmm. we're going.
Mm-hmm.
So they might slip and fall.
Mm-hmm.
That ball is dry in the early part of the game. It might mm-hmm. get wet later on. Mm-hmm. So we got to throw it early. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But we still got to run the ball, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Find a run game.
But both teams are good. And do you think it's going to be a good game?
Absolutely. It's the playoffs.
Uh-huh.
You know how it is. You've seen them.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And they don't look good, but they're decent. They're decent,
Then we don't look good either. We're decent, real.
Hey, I'm going to tell you something, Jay Fresh. Hey, it look like you've been doing your homework, man. You doing your study and the other fan. I ain't even know all that, man.
Yeah.
So, I'm glad that we got you here, man, so you can keep us straight, keep us informed, tell us what we got to look for, man. So, hey, what you think about this game coming up?
It's
going
to be a good game, and hopefully we could beat them. My score prediction is... It's 30-28 us.
Okay.
I like that. As long as you say us, I'm in good shape.
Now, Coach Woody.
Yes, sir.
I don't even know how to follow this up, man. He didn't ask all the questions.
Yeah.
He got everything going on. That's my man Jay Fresh right there. Jay Fresh, you see him? Fresh is so clean with the fives on. He got the hardest shoe collection in the game, man. Get with my man Jay Fresh. But hey, Woody.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is a win or go home situation.
Absolutely.
You've been here before, man. There's nothing. I mean, you know, there's nothing that the kids is going that they don't know. You know, and they're gonna be prepared and they're gonna be ready. But just talk a little bit about that Louisa team, man. Just talk to us about the size as being one of their things that sticks out the most. Just talk to us a little bit about this matchup.
I'm gonna stop you. I'm gonna question you. Not really question you, but I'm gonna say something. A lot of these kids have never been in this situation.
Well, no doubt. But you got to understand.
But I've been here and done that.
Yeah, you've been here and done that, but you got to understand.
These coaches have been here and done that.
Yeah, but these kids, they used to playing big-time games now, coming up all the way through.
Expectations.
They look for it, no doubt.
Mission December. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Great teams play in December. Good teams play in November.
No doubt.
We got our hands full, no doubt. They're big up front, as you had mentioned. That 97, that 52. They're running that 3-4, but they can also adjust to a 4-2-5. And, ultimately speaking, at some point in time, as we always say, we got to put our hand in the ground and we got to get 3 yards in a cloud of dust when we need it.
No doubt.
When we need it.
Yeah.
Our strength is being able to throw the football. George has done a good job. He's got a lot of athletes out wide that we can toss it to. To me, it seems like they're in a man-to-man type coverage that plays into our favor. I shouldn't say that on Drake and Talk.
We keep it 100 on the show, man. Yeah. We talking like it is what it is. Is this what you feel? This what you feel?
Yeah, I do feel it.
Yeah.
I do feel it. My man Eli.
Yeah.
Offensive Player of the Year.
Shout out to Eli Woods, Seminole District Offensive Player of the Year.
Did you know that?
Yeah.
Yep, he already knew.
Jay Fresh know everything, man. He keep me in the loop now. He my new source.
All right, so in 5-21, we got to be able to run the ball again, though. So what does 5-21 look like in the run game? What does 2 look like in the run game? We got Neo Corsini back.
Yeah, up front. Big. That's yes, big. That's
he missed the last 2 games.
Yeah.
And so that helps us push people around up front a little bit, both sides of the ball. But it's. I mean, I got back in the bag. Man, I've got a whole lot of formations. I got a whole lot of more motions. I got a whole lot of, you know, trickery, chicanery. And chicanery is, you know, again, running a bootleg pass on 4th-and-1 on the goal line.
No doubt. Yeah.
So it's, you know, kids are excited. We've been all in. Key is the quick turnaround.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We played Friday. Tough game. We're banged up. We're not injured. We're just banged up.
Physical game.
Yeah, physical game. Yeah. And now we got to get back to life, get back to reality on Thursday, not Friday fresh. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
So we don't have that extra day. We had to hustle.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's going to be a good one. And the game is not Friday. It is Thursday, which is tomorrow at 7 o'clock at City Stadium. You have the EC Glass Hilltoppers, our EC Glass Hilltoppers. We got some uninvited guests that's coming in, so we must protect our turf. If you ain't doing nothing, come on out and support these boys. Like we told you before, it's the 4-3-4. When we ain't playing against each other, we're going to ride for each other.
Yes,
so this has been Dre Kendrick, my man Jay Fresh, my man Wu-Tang Clan. What you got to say? You got something to say before
we
go?
No, I just say they better wipe their feet.
Wipe their feet. So, hey, this us, and guess what? We are what?
Ow!
All right.
Thank you guys for watching Drake and Talk. Be on the lookout for more exclusive content. Like, share, subscribe. Drake and Talk, out.